Thank you. I think it's so important to increase citizen participation as much as we can in people's schools and people's elected. I noticed your bylaws haven't been updated for about 12 years, and I have some suggestions that I will pass out to you. I think it's important for each board member to have a microphone right at their seat at the dais. Some of us are a little hard of hearing, and it's confusing exactly where you are in the agenda and what's being spoken. So if you could maybe get some ADA funds and get a microphone for each seat, that would be very much appreciated. Also, if you could clearly state on the agenda after each item, public comment period, and call for public comment after each item, then it would be more clear when we could speak, when we're finished with the discussion, but of course before the vote. That would be very helpful. I noticed in your bylaws and protocols that student learning and achievement kind of takes a back seat. Goals aren't mentioned. I think it's really important to include goals, not just student success. How do you measure student success? How do you measure learning and achievement? Do you look at individual student growth year to year? Does your curriculum have rigorous content? Do you increase the percentage of students that are taking advanced placement calculus classes and passing that test in springtime? That gives you a clear idea of your content in your curriculum, if it's rigorous, and if your students are prepared to take those courses. I was surprised as I drove by the school to see a sign on, it's a big banner on the fence. Don't drink and drive, and how dangerous that is. It's very well known locally that you condone that behavior when you had an educator that was charged, and I think convicted, of driving drunk. Educators are held to a higher standard. Perhaps there was a conflict of interest with the board at that time, but we're not defined by the banners we have on the fence, but what we put up with. That's really important for students. They're always watching. What are you doing? Another thing, I think that if you could change the chairs, if the superintendent and Mrs. Lewis could be on the side, and the board members could be at the front and not going off to the side, it kind of becomes the superintendent's meeting instead of the board and the citizens. I think it would be helpful to physically relocate. And here are those copies.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
I didn't. Do you have
consent agenda?
Consent agenda?
What was your plan?
My plan was to have off item six. Is there any discussion? So if there are some items, please bring them forward.
Item 1A.
Yes.
I'm still not happy with the March minutes. Given before, but I wish would be written about the report that I read in March, and it still isn't reflecting what I requested.
And the policy or the practice, and Scott, you can is that we state who spoke and what the topic was.
And that's not even the proper topic. If you were going to cut off half of the topic, that has to be put in there. You cut off the wrong half, because this represents a minority of what I spoke about. And you know, point of clarification, if you look at the California School Board Association handbook, which we all have, there's actually a paragraph in there where they define what the word minutes means. And the document that's referred to the minutes is supposed to have a fair representation of all of the minutes of the board meeting. It's not to be a compacted, brief overview, especially in a forum like we have, where the board has long ago decided not to make an official recording of it. And those recordings that Scott said he does have are in some drawer, but it's not part of our routine or your past board meetings from years ago. Anyway, my point is there needs, if we aren't going to have minutes that are a true reflection of what was said by whom, then we need to have a board sanctioned audio or video recording of the board minutes and the end of the board meeting. That needs to then be on the website so that people can access it and review it. So then I would ask that again, we don't vote on the March minutes.
So do we need to amend the motion and let's bring it back to, is that what?
You can amend it right now, just please insert what I've been asking to be inserted.
Okay, I'll move that we amend the consent agenda, pulling the March 12, 2019 minutes and moving them to the June 25th board meeting for approval.
Do you want to second?
Yeah.
Okay.
Please.
There are several items that we were sent in our board packet that I was unable to find on the agenda, and it may just be because I didn't understand which of these sub-letters they belong. So I will just ask you, Janet, if this is the opportune time for me to talk about some questions I have. For example, dealing with changing the hours of refusion of high school. Is that within?
Changing the hours?
So we're not changing the hours, we're applying the structural minutes.
Fine. Yeah. But that's the topic. So is that within the consent agenda?
No, it's been out. Is there a discussion item?
It is on consent.
G1.
It's 3C.
Okay. Forgive me on that, but while I have the opportunity, is I wanted to ask a question about Genevieve Bishop's resignation.
Sure.
Is this related to that?
Yes.
Will she be replaced?
Yes, she'll be replaced. That's correct.
Yes, and so that's a biology class that's not going to be discontinued.
Another approach is with the exception of, well, have to figure out what we do in terms of whoever's hired, qualifications to teach, so they're ag and stuff, but no better ag that person.
Speaking of ag, Yes, approval of agricultural career technical education incentive grant.
Sure.
I just had a comment. I was totally amazed, if I did the math right, I might understand 27% of our student body is taking this agricultural class.
Not just that, but our ag-related, about a third of our students are roughly a third of all the ag is correct. It's amazing. Yeah, no, it's a cornerstone for sure.
And that's important when we're trying to decide about application of funds. I had no idea that there was such a large percentage. Scott, is this, or Jan, is this the time for me to make a comment about the CLC application for a contract? And at the same time, same question, I'm going to just to combine the contract with the attorneys.
So that's outside of consent, so we should stick to what's inside.
Okay, that's
so,
fine.
So John, that's item 2H, correct, the CLC. Easier if you can.
I know. The problem is 485 pages.
I know.
It was given to me just 3 or 4 days ago.
And we're all in the same boat.
Swamped. So my question and comment on this is, was there any attempt to negotiate this contract? Because for this individual to be asking for $200 an hour, even though it's capped, I have a little tough time with that, just because even though the maximum the contract says that she can build a district is $20,000, I get that, and then a $12+ million budget, that's a drop in the bucket. I get it. But the optics, when we furloughed staff, when we've released staff, I want the district to realize that we are pinching every penny we can and every dollar saved. And what I would have suggested, had I had the luxury of being involved in negotiating this contract, and I'm out of order, but I'll say the same thing. My same comments apply to the attorneys, their contract, is I know from personal experience that if you offer professionals like this a retainer, it puts you in the driver's seat in being able to negotiate down their hourly wage, because they're not expending expensive staff funds trying to collect. They're not having to wait 30, 60, 90 days on their receivables. They've got the money instantly. And that's what I would have suggested, is we say, if we give you a $20,000 retainer up front, and you're still held equally accountable for the expenditure of those funds, then how much off that $200 an hour are you willing to go?
I can address briefly. We're not allowed to do retainers very often, with just a few select circumstances with attorneys, and only in very rare circumstances being allowed. The county office won't approve warrants without billable hours as proof. So it's very rare that they will allow retainers, and specifically retainers outside of the legal arena. It's very rare. It's very hard to get them to approve. So that's one reason why it's not commonly done in education.
Well, that's unfortunate, but I get it. I believe you, but still, I just asked my opening question, was there any type of negotiating done, even if the retainer is not part of the conversation?
No, that's actually been her rate. It should be for retainer services for at least 3 years, maybe four years. But that has been her rate from the beginning, if I recall correctly, when we interviewed a couple of different firms for that service.
So
the rate has not increased in those years.
In the time that she has been working with us through the contract, how much money have we received because of her?
Currently applying for $7 million, another $1.3 going in this month.
So once we haven't received it, but
right
on.
Right, okay, so it benefits us to have her firm continue to provide these services to us.
Well, I wasn't suggesting that.
Yeah, okay. I just want to make sure that we were.
You just talk about the rate. Okay. At least that went some of this stuff before, too.
Right.
Wrong.
You're just
trying to scotch her out of some money. That's it.
Okay.
Scott, I made a comment to you on the phone. Is this the opportune time for me to ask my question about the subject of San Diego's Valley High School portable roofing improvements?
interaction.
And everything else I have is add plus LPAT questions.
Okay, great. Okay, so we have an amendment to the original motion to approve consent agenda, right? So, with that is a roll call vote. Okay, Dr. McGee?
Aye.
Aye.
Ms. Brenner?
Aye.
Ms. Dattler?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, motion carries five zero.
Just for the record, the resident of Jenny Bishop, she's been an outstanding educator for us, and she's been really, really good. She's choosing to be with her children, and but she will be able, she's been really fantastic. Between her and her Clement, our ag program is spectacular, so a good job. The other piece of note on there is Steve Gunning is a substitute teacher, which is fantastic. Steve retired several years ago, and now is able to come back and sub, and it's just a fantastic guy. What's that? Sub in general, as far as I know. And also, pleased to note as well that substitutes are just approved is probably one of the biggest we've had in a while, and that's been a significant need. But Steve coming back on campus, that's a win.
That's good. All right, let's move along to item B, the action agenda. So the first item is, number one is approval of resolution 2018-2019-23 regarding Brannan Incorporated doing business as Smith Electric, phase two modernization notice of completion.
That scope of work is completed, has been signed off for them to acquire the retention funds now that they're holding on to. Just need board action to make that happen.
Do we have a motion to approve? So moved. We have a second.
Second.
A motion and a second to approve the resolution 2018-2019-23. Are there any questions? Okay. Questions? Roll call vote.
Okay, Dr. McGee?
Aye.
Mrs. Preston?
Aye.
Mrs. Brenner?
Aye.
Mrs. Dattler?
Aye.
Mrs. Clement?
Aye. Motion carries 5-0. Item two, approval of resolution 2018-2019-24 regarding Pacific Coast Sound and Communications phase two modernization notice of completion.
Same reasoning as for number one, the scope of work is complete, everything is functioning well, it's been signed up.
Okay, do I have a motion to approve? So moved. Lori?
Second.
All right. Tori and I, excuse me. Okay, is there any questions or discussion? All right, roll call please.
Dr. McGee? Mrs. Preston?
Aye.
Mrs. Brenner?
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries 5-0. Let's go on to item three, approval of education protection account resolution 2018-19-22, 1920 budget of revenue and expenditures, and report of estimated revenues and expenditures for 2018-19. This is Alicia.
So every year we receive education protection account fund. These funds are restricted funds. They have to be spent on specific things. One thing that they may not be spent on is any type of administration. So every year, as a requirement for receiving
discussion on Chris.
Second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second to approve the PA resolution. Discussion or questions? Okay, we'll call please.
Dr. Rainey?
Aye.
Mrs. Preston?
Aye.
Mrs. Burton?
Aye.
Mrs. Babcock?
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries 5-0. All right, item four, approval of contract for professional services, Ynez, Woolworth, Kelly, attorneys at law. Scott?
Yep, we have several different firms that we actually work with, and EWK, it's created for, it's, we'd like to retain their services. And so it's the service contract for that. John, have comments, questions on that? You want to address that now, similar to what you said before?
Same thing, even though Alicia said that it's rarely done, in my mind, rarely doesn't mean never.
Correct, and notable with attorney firms with one exception.
Do we have, a motion? First, need a motion to drop the comments.
Okay.
Do we have a motion?
I would approve.
Second, please.
I'll second.
All right. Sorry, first one. Okay, I need to